fishing with Gary Senft at the live at the Bass Pro Shop. So here we go. We're gonna tie on a polymer knot drop shot. Let me show you a little tips and some of the things I do, okay? And we got a few guys here that are standing by that are in our little seminar today. So they're gonna probably ask some questions eventually, what's happening and what's gonna happen. So right now I'm opening size one of the Bass Pro Shop hooks. So I use just about everything Bass Pro. I use the hooks, I use the drop shot weights, I use the bobber stoppers. And by the way, when I get to the bobber stopper segment, that's one of the most asked questions I have about how I rig up my bobber stoppers. First, we're gonna do the polymer knot section, then we're gonna go into the bobber stoppers and what they do. So, right now we have the brand new Johnny Morris spinning rod and reel. Okay, this just came out for 2018. I like using a 6.9 spinning reel. It's a medium with a medium fast tip, you know. So you need something, if you're gonna drop shot, you need something that you can feel those fish bite, because right now it's wintertime and the conditions are really tough out there. They don't sit there and jerk on your line. They don't hit it. What they do is they just pick it up, put it in their mouth, and they sit there. So if you go to lift up, you gotta be able to tell that that bait is in their mouth and set the hook. And the most important part about bass fishing is setting that hook. If you just lift up, it's not setting the hook. You've actually physically gotta jerk that rod to set that hook in their mouth because of the bony conditions. And if you're at the Bass Pro Shop, you can come over here and you can look in the aquarium and see all the fish, you know, swimming around. Now they're all getting activated because they feed these fish about 2 o'clock. So they think we're here to feed them. So let's go ahead and start this. I'm using 8-pound test, okay, XPS line. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take out a number one, not a one knot, but a one. And I'm gonna show you some of the tricks that I use to get more hook sets. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm going to show you the hook. Now I bend this hook 3 degrees. Okay, so there's the hook right there. And I also have the little, this part like this. It's a regular bass hook, all right? And some people say, well, why do you use that and why don't you use the little drop shot hook? You know, there's nothing wrong with the open hook, but where I fish, if there's a tree close by, I'm gonna drop that bait right down the middle of that tree. So if you drop an open hook down in the middle of the tree, you're not gonna be getting it back. You're gonna be breaking off all the time. So that's the reason I Texas rig my drop shot, all right? It works for me, but it may not work for you. Everybody else has a different version. I'm just telling you my segment of this, and it works for me. I catch a lot of fish on drop shot, all right? So as I'm looking at that hook like this, all right, I'm going to bend that to my left about 3 degrees, and that's not much. I'm just gonna hold it. And now, I don't know if you can see that, but you can see that that hook is bent. Okay, so the main thing you start with is you hold that fish hook towards you. So this is away from you, this is towards you. I'm gonna take this line, 8-pound test. All right, we're gonna feed the line through the hook as the hook is point it towards me, and I'm gonna pull out about 10 inches, all right? Then, I'm going to take the tag end of the line, and I'm gonna go back through the same way. So if I was to keep pulling this, I would pull that hook all the way through, okay? This is called a polymer knot. All we have to do is just tie an overhand knot. Just an overhand shoestring knot. Just tighten it up. You don't have to pull it very, very tight. Now, I'm going to pass this hook through that loop right there. So I'm just gonna pass it through there, and I'm gonna pull all the strings together like this. You wanna actually wet it because your line can burn. And I'm just gonna pull that tight, all right? All right, so now we have the hook positioned up the line. But you notice that the hook is pointing downwards, and this is where the weight's gonna be? That's not the right way, all right? So I have to change the direction of that hook. A simple way of doing that, the hook should be this way and not that way. So what I'm gonna do is take the tag end of that line, and I'm going to put it right through the front of the hook again. And I'm gonna pull that all the way through. Now that's gonna change the hook going the other way. See how the hook is pointed the opposite way? That it stopped moving. You can see that that hook is pointed upwards like this, instead of like this. You don't want the hook going down, you want that hook going up so that it catches that fish in the upper part of the mouth. It shouldn't be like that. It should be like that. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is put on the sinker. And this is a made for the drop shot. It's actually Bass Pro Shop drop shot. It's 3/16. So we're going to put that right through. Okay, we're gonna go through the clasp. All we gotta do is just bring that through. Now, these things are made to just hook on there like that, all right? I go one step further. If they barely get hooked in a rock and you pull it, it's gonna break off. So what I do is I tie one extra knot. That's all I do. Sometimes two, but most of the time one knot, just an overhand knot. Now, that's gonna hold a lot more strength. And if I do get stuck, I can pull it and it can break. So we're just gonna trim that off. Okay, you can see that I have about 10 to 12 inches from the hook down to here. That's probably the best length that I can tell you out of all the years I've been fishing that this should be at length there, 12 inches, 10 to 12 inches. Some people say, well, 2 feet is my length. That's okay. You can do 2 feet, 6 inches. It doesn't, you know, whatever you think is best that you catch your fish on, that's gonna be what it is. The next method I have about drop shot, the second segment of this, is gonna show you something entirely different about drop shot. So let me thread this hook on here. If I could pick one worm out of the 5 million worms back in the back, I would pick a robo worm. And it's gonna be the morning dawn with chartreuse. That would be my number one choice out of all those worms. Now, there are a lot of other worms back there that work. So I'm gonna go in about 1/8 of the way up on the hook. I'm going to thread that all the way up on the keeper part of the hook, that little whoop-de-doo in the hook. Slide that all the way up like this, all right? And then I'm gonna turn around and I'm gonna turn this hook around and I'm gonna make this hook completely weedless. Because remember I told you that's why I use a long shank hook, is because if I'm in I see a tree, I'm in the tree, right in the middle. If your hook is exposed, you're not gonna get your hook back. You're gonna be stuck. But this makes it entirely weedless, all right? You wanna get that hook as straight as possible, all right? So if I go to grab that hook, you know, my finger's gonna get stuck on that hook. It's stuck. So I don't wanna punch it all the way through. Sometimes I'll put it all the way through, then I'll skin hook it again. This is the typical drop shot situation that everybody uses, all right? Remember, some use a real long length, some use a short length. I use a short length. I like the 10 inches or 12 inches because I think I've been fishing my whole life, 50, 60 years in Arizona, and that's been the best situation for me. You know, this longer length, 2 feet, might work in California or it might work in South Carolina, North Carolina. You know, that might be different there, but this works for me here. And then when I get to the second segment of this, I'm gonna add you a few more tricks and show you something else. So we've got a few people over here that are standing by and they might want to ask a question or two about different things. Do you guys have any questions at all about what you see here about the drop shot? Okay.
So why do you prefer straight tail over curly tail?
Okay. He's asking, why am I using a straight tail worm over a curly tail worm? I use both, actually. Sometimes when the bite is extremely tough, like right now in the wintertime, sometimes the curly tail is a lot better. You're right, that's a good question, you know. If they're not biting on the straight tail, I will substitute for a curly tail. And this is a 6-inch worm right here, and it's made by Robo Worms, Hot Tips. The curly tail is made by Robo Worm also, and it's 5.5 inches long instead of 6. But basically just as good. And the curly tail does have a better disposition in water. It moves a little bit more water when you're throwing it in or picking it up and dropping. But good question. Anybody else?
Can you put a scent on that?
Okay. This guy asked, Bob asked, do I use a scent? Yes, I do use a scent. When the bite is real good, you can get by without a scent, but when the bite is really bad and it's really tough in the wintertime, you should be spraying your worms or your brush hogs or whatever you're using with a scent. You know, my scent I use is Bang. My flavor I use is garlic. For some reason, the fish love garlic. So when they bite on that worm and you have a little bit of garlic taste on there, they could taste that and they hold on to it just that much more better. Another thing too, if you use the dark garlic dip to dip the tail, that also has a scent on it also. So I use a lot of dipping for the tails and stuff, you know. Anybody else have any other questions?
Yeah.
Okay.
Your hook set, since that's a thin worm and a thin wire hook, is that different than a regular hook set?
He asked, since that hook is very thin and it's a long shank hook, right? It's a little different. One thing, because I explained the shank is gonna allow me to rig this Texas style. I like the thickness of the hook to be smaller. The thicker the hook, the bigger the diameter of the hook, and bigger, you have to jerk that rod that much more to get that hook in the roof of the mouth of that fish. With a thin wire like this, it just takes pop and it's done. That just all it is, it's all in the wrist, pop. And then that hooks that fish every time. But you have to set the hook. If you don't set it and you go, oh, I think I got a bite, and you lift up like this and your rod bends way over like this and you go, oh, I got a fish on, you start reeling. By the time you get the fish to the surface, he's gonna come off, all right? You know, with all the guiding I do and taking people fishing for the fun of it and stuff, they have to set that hook. That's a good question. Paul?
Well, now, I'm new to this, so I get confused with all of the colors of the worm. How do I know what's good for a particular area?
Oh, there you go, a newcomer to fishing. He's brand new to bass fishing, you know? So we handpick some people out of the audience that, you know, some are better, some fish every weekend. So Paul's brand new to this, and he says, what colors is different? I always keep a number of colors that are good. Morning Dawn with chartreuse would be number one, all right? Let me pick out another one here. So my favorites, are Morning Dawn with chartreuse. Also, if you stick to the pumpkin or the brown, that's another good one. If you stick to your neutral colors, that's always good. Watermelon black flake, that's another good one. That's also a good one too. So there's a lot that Bass Pro makes, you know, a watermelon curly tail. Remember we talked about curly tails just a little bit ago. You know, this is a Zoom product. That tail is gonna make a lot more disturbance in the water than that straight tail is gonna make, you know. Now those are all good questions, you know. Everybody has a different technique when they fish, because I've been doing these seminars for 20, 30 years, and there's no wrong way of fishing. Every one of these guys could fish this drop shot in a different way and catch fish. Hey, I just wanna say thank you for watching Fishing with Gary Senft live at the Bass Pro Shop.